Today, I'm going to talk about Da Vinci brushes and why I love them so much.
That the entirety of the cosmos is accessible through each and every individual's mind, connected to the great mind, the great spirit.
Welcome back to the channel, collectors. So today I'm going to talk about my favorite brush range, Da Vinci, and specifically Series 35. So I've been using Da Vinci brushes for the past 2 years or so, and I've never looked back ever since I've started using them. So as a miniature painter, you should know that brushes are the thing that you use the most other than your eyes and your hands to create your miniature works of art. So being a full-time commission painter for the past 3 years, I've been using many different brushes, all the way from the cheap Kolectiv brushes, just your regular art store brushes, all the way to Winsor Newton Series 7, and now Da Vinci. So here are some of the features which I really like in the Da Vinci Series 35 brush range. So first and foremost, the Da Vinci Series 35 has really long bristles. What I like about the really long bristles is that it allows the brush to maintain a very fine and sharp tip, which is very useful for miniature painting and creating that little bit of detail. However, one downside to having really long brushes is that these bristles make it increasingly hard to stipple, and sometimes having a long bristle makes it really unwieldy to reach those really hard to reach places. However, these can be mitigated as long as you practice enough and just get used to the brush. Next feature I really appreciate from the Da Vinci Series 35 is that it has a really wide belly. Such a fine tip brush, the Da Vinci Series 35 does have a very wide belly, and it allows a lot of paint to be stored so that you can continuously paint and paint with the same brush in one load, and you don't have to consistently top up the paint in your brush, which makes painting a lot more consistent. So the next point I really like about the Da Vinci Series 35 is that it has really firm bristles. So this firmness of the bristles really help when you're doing edge highlighting, and it really helps control the brush so that it allows the paintbrush to perform optimally, even though sometimes your brush control and your brush pressure isn't as optimal as possible. And the last point is definitely cost. At SGD 16 for the smaller brushes and $18 for the larger, for size 2 brushes, the cost is really phenomenally low, because these brushes are almost bomb-proof. I paint every day and sometimes up to 8 hours a day, and I only replace my brushes once every 6 months or sometimes even less. This makes the cost saving so much less and the consistency of your brush so much more, because as a miniature painter, you really want the brush to be the same every stroke. However, with cheaper brushes, of course, there's always the argument where you can use a cheaper brush and you can replace and have a sharp tip every single month. But do note that brush making is an art form, and every single brush is unique. So you would take some time to get used to the brush, and by the time you get used to the brush will need to be replaced. So this is why I feel that over the months, I would prefer using a good brush to last the entire duration. So these are my views about the Da Vinci Series 35. What other brushes do you use for your miniature painting? Let me know in the comments below. And you guys know the drill, like, subscribe, all the other stuff if you guys want to see more of such videos, alright? And if you can afford it, go on, be a Patreon today. I really appreciate the support from all my patrons, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. See you!